next, it's the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour, the longest game show title ever, followed by Classic Concentration, the second longest game show title ever. Stay tuned.
It's all the time we have. We'll see you next time on Card Sharks. Bye-bye.
Some of our young Card Sharks will receive Kentucky Fried Chicken, new Chicken Little sandwiches. They cost just a little, but people love them a lot, only from Kentucky Fried Chicken. Sun-Made Fruit Bits, a delicious snack with a natural goodness of real fruit. Enjoy a tempting fruit snack from Sun-Made. Shampoo, conditioner, and gel, dermatologically certified for purity, sold exclusively at Fantastic Sam Salons. Be creative with Handy Crafts, another great way to use Handy Wipes, America's favorite reusable cleaning cloth. Contact Nighttime Cold Medicine, effective relief for the taste preferred 2-to-1 over the leading nighttime liquid cold formula. Shield deodorant soap. It keeps you feeling fresh and clean all day long. Feel fresh the whole day through with Shield. Olympia's desktop EC 2000 calculators feature packed and specially designed to handle even the most difficult calculating tasks from Olympia USA. And a member of our studio audience will receive Scott's Hi-Fi Stereo VCR with 7-head system, 139-channel, cable-ready, 14-day, 8-event programming, and wireless remote from H.H. Scott. This is Gene Wood speaking for Card Sharks, a Mark Goodson television production.
Hey, Buzzer fans, Bob Eubanks here. Hey, I picked this episode of Match Game Hollywood Squares because John Bellman was my neighbor, and I had so much fun. Watch.
It's time for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour with Charles Nelson Reilly. From another world, Nancy Frangione. Aaron Murray. From Scarecrow, Mrs. King, Martha Smith. From Old Madeline, James White. And the stars of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn and John.
I just hope you survive this hour. We hope to survive this hour. All ready to have a go at it? You got off to a good start with your distinctive funny walks, your entrances there and all that sort of thing, and I thank you for that. Everything okay?
The perfumes are good, too.
Yes.
Isn't that good?
Mm.
It's not edible.
Doesn't taste bad, either. All right.
Stay away from my neck.
Let's begin. Let's begin by greeting our two players here, Ray Evanstad and Charlotte Turk. Great. Hello there.
How do you do?
Now, let's get acquainted. Ray, tell us about you, please.
I was born in Manhattan Beach, California, 1912.
1912. She's telling everything. No secrets this lady has.
And now that my family's all grown up, I'm doing everything I wanted to do when I was a youngster. And, for instance, for my 69th birthday, I made my first parachute jump.
No kidding. Where'd you do that?
At Paris Valley.
Really? Yeah,
and I gave myself a birthday party, and I invited 250 people and asked them all, in lieu of a birthday gift, to bring a check for $5 for the abused children. And we raised over $1,500 for the abused children.
How wonderful.
So I thought I can die with a clear conscience.
Congratulations to you. You're a public-spirited woman. Thank you. Now, Charlotte, let's hear about you.
Well, I'm a native Texan. I'm from Arlington, which is right between Dallas and Fort Worth. I've been in California for 9 months, and I work and go to school here.
You ever go to J.T. Garcia's?
No. Joe T. Garcia's
Joe
in
T.
Fort
Gar-
Worth?
T.
Sure. Yeah. It's fantastic.
Yeah. I did a play in Dallas, Texas once, and you spent all your time going to this wonderful Tex-Mex restaurant.
That's great,
and
he's
really good. Yes. All right. Let's play the match game. You'll have three chances to match as many of the loonies as you can, and the one who's done that most often will be the winner and go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Ray, you won the toss, so you go first.
Hey.
A it is for you. Let's see what we got for Ray here.
Hey, Ray.
Public-spirited citizen. Joey said, A bucket of grease fell on my head the other day, and somebody asked me for my autograph. You know why? He thought I was blank.
What? Ah. Oh, my God.
Grease on the head, you see.
Bucket of grease
fell on my head.
And someone asked for an autograph.
Yes, and he asked for the autograph because he thought I was... because all the grease was on my head. You understand right now? Oh, boy.
Oh, no.
You don't know? Ray, think about this now. The other day, Joey said, a bucket of grease fell on my head the other day, and somebody asked me for my autograph. And you know why? He thought I was blank.
A grease ball.
Yeah, we were thinking of someone a little more specific than that, but one of these dingbats might have said grease ball. You never know. What'd you say, Jim?
Do-do-do-do-do. Bowser.
Bowser.
Thank you, Snowmatch.
In his other life, when he used to be Bowser...
I didn't see Bowser.
You never saw Sha-na-na?
Sha-na-na.
Oh, well, then...
We've been on in the past 72 years, Ray.
What'd you say, Aaron? Bowser, that's two of those. All right, Nancy? That's three Bowsers. And what did Bowser say?
Well, I decided to give a lesser-known guy a break. So I said John Travolta.
That's right. Remember, he had very slick-down, greasy hair in some of his movies?
He needs the publicity.
Right.
Well,
Martha?
Grease, he was the star.
I cheated. I said John Travolta.
You said John Travolta. Okay, Chuck.
John Travolta.
All right. So three John Travoltas, three Bowsers. All right, you, that was just kind of a warm-up question. Ray, don't worry about it. Fat Frida said, she said, I just bought the world's most delicious padded bra. Instead of foam, it's padded with blank.
Wait, who said that?
Fat Frida.
Oh. Thank you, Jake.
All right. Jim, we're waiting for you.
Right.
Hi, James.
I don't know why. I just said
all right. Charlotte. Fat Frida said, I just bought the world's most delicious padded bra. Instead of foam, it's padded with blank.
Sponge cake.
Sponge cake. Aha!
Good.
That's what I,
that was good.
When I said I had an answer in my head, that's what I was thinking of.
No, it's good.
Sponge cake.
This is early. What can I tell you?
It's early.
For some reason, I came up with ice cream. I don't know why.
Ice cream.
Yes.
Ice
cream. It's been a strange day. Well.
It's delicious melted.
Oh, you're gonna mine too.
She
no,
looks great for
delicious.
About 20 minutes.
Oh, yeah. And the heat gets to her. What'd you say, Aaron?
I said cantaloupe.
You said cantaloupe. And she spelled it correctly, you notice. What do you
well,
say?
Well, I don't know. I buy mine on 42nd Street. It goes bad quickly, but
whipped cream. Will that stand up?
Whip it very well.
I see. Oh, you're all right. All right, John, you're up. Instead of foam, it's padded with.
It's just the first thing that popped into my head. Peter Paul Mounds.
Ah, good response.
That is good.
Good response.
That's a first round question. A lot of good answers.
I think it's a very appropriate answer. What do you say, Martha?
Well, I used to see Nancy all the time over there on 42nd Street buying bras, and I said whipped cream.
Whipped cream. Uh-huh.
See?
Yeah.
All right, Charles?
Yes. Yeah.
From the seashore, cotton candy.
Aha, uh-huh, another good one. Some nifty answers there. So there's round one. Round two is coming up in a moment. 0-0 the score at the moment. Hurry right back after these messages. Here we go. Round two coming up. There are the questions. Now, since the score is tied, and Ray went first last time, Charlotte, you may go first this time. Before you make your selection, may I ask Mark Breslow to get a tight shot of Charlotte's eyes? She has the most unusual eye makeup I have ever seen. Close your eyes for a second there. One half is one color, and one half, isn't that attractive? I've never seen that before. Is that your own idea?
Well, that's very good. I read about it in a magazine.
You what?
I read about it in a magazine.
All right, you want A or B, Charlotte?
I'll take B, please.
B. All right, that's it. Tom said, no wonder Jane Fonda is in such good shape. Every morning she does 50 blanks with her tongue. All right. You're a very creative, imaginative bunch. I've seen a couple of your answers. All right. Doing a little artwork, Chuck?
No.
All right. Charlotte. Tom said, no wonder Jane Fonda is in such good shape. Every morning she does 50 blanks with her tongue.
Push-ups.
Push-ups with her tongue. All right. That'd be tough, wouldn't it? 50 push-ups. There are other good possibilities here, too. James, do you have one of them?
Well, seeing that she's very busy in communication, I said phone calls.
Phone calls? She dials. Now, that'd be difficult to do a rotary dialer with your tongue. You go, Oh, I mustn't do that. Hello, Aaron.
I said tongue-ups.
Tongue-ups? She said tongue-ups. It's
rip-off.
Isn't that close enough to push-ups? No, it isn't.
Oh.
No, wait a minute.
Do you think it is, huh?
Well, Judge Watt.
The judge does not.
There's Jane doing her tongue-ups.
Pull-ups
with her tongue.
Yeah. All right. Charlotte said push-ups. That hasn't occurred here yet. Let's see if John has it.
I said 50 laps.
50 laps with her tongue. All right, Martha. Yeah.
She said 50 toe touches with her tongue. It's
50 toe touches. That'd be difficult, wouldn't it? You have to be very limber to do that. Charles?
In 1942, I had the same eye coloring on one eye.
You did? You created that
No, the bully gave me a black eye in PS53. The correct answer.
Push up. Boy, this is a tough game. Ray, you ready?
Here it is.
All right.
Here we go.
Dumb Dora is so dumb. I'll tell you how dumb she is. She bought an ant farm, only instead of putting ants in it, she put blanks in it. Good. What's going on?
Nothing.
I got it.
Okay. All right, Ray, I guess we're ready for you. Dumb Dora is so dumb, she bought an ant farm, only instead of putting ants in it, she put blanks in it.
Fleas.
Fleas. You sure that's your answer, huh?
I'm stuck with it.
All right, that's the only thing you could think of. First thing you thought of. James, what do you say?
I said she puts uncles in.
Had a way to go.
Uncles. Perfect.
Uncle seems to be the popular fave here, Aaron.
Not mine.
No?
No.
What do you say?
Anteaters.
Anteaters. That's good. I think that's good. That's good. It's imaginative and it's amusing.
Not that good, Gene.
No?
No, even though we from Cape Cod call them aunts.
Oh, you say aunts, right.
Yes, aunts.
Okay. I forgot. I should have said aunt for your benefit there. She's looking for fleas.
Yes. Even though I'm Bowser, you won't find any here. You have a great future in parachute jumping, though. Ray, I said uncles.
All right. Uncles would have worked very well for you if you thought of it. Yeah. Martha, what have you got?
Surprise. Uncles.
Uncles. Charles, are you going to be...
I'm from the Tex-Mex area myself, so I say uncle.
Okay. Don't tangle with Charles. So Charlotte's ahead at the end of round two. 1-0. Round three, the final round, right after this. Third and final round. Here we go. Charlotte, you're ahead. You go first.
B, please.
All right, let's see what B says. Five people play. Everyone except Chuck, who is a perfect person, remember, he matched her. Walt said, did you hear that they're doing a sequel to the movie Flashdance? This one is about a lady plumber. It's called Blank Dance. Charlotte, we're about ready for you. Walt said, did you hear that they're doing a sequel to the movie Flashdance? This one is about a lady plumber. It's called Blank Dance.
Flush Dance?
Flush Dance. Jim, are you on the track?
Hey, I said Flush Dance.
You said Flush Dance. Well, I was too.
Flush.
That's
boy.
All right, she's up to three. Miss Nancy. Drain dance. Drain dance.
They don't flush in Cape Cod.
They don't flush in Cape Cod. Well, I'm not going to respond to that. Okay, John, what do you say? It's called...
This could really ruin your eye makeup. Flush dance.
Yeah. All right, four for her. Martha?
They don't flush in Detroit. Drain dance.
Drain dance.
See?
You two have been on the same wavelength all day there. Now, Ray, here's a chance to catch up. You need four to tie and five to win. Ready? Old Lady Periwinkle set.
Help me, help me.
Here she comes.
Ooh. Ooh. How old are you, son?
I'm 36, dear.
You're too old for me.
Truth hurts, doesn't it?
Let me tell you. Out at the home, we have our own magazine, and I'm the centerfold. That's because my blanks fold out.
Old Lady Periwinkle is speaking.
Yeah, right.
Not me.
Imagine his hands and tell me that. That's because my blanks fold out.
The lady sorority is meeting.
It's over here.
Okay.
The groom.
I got it.
All right. Put it in the slot. Jim, is yours in the slot?
Yes, yes, yes. I have it. I bring it in there.
No. Okay. Got it.
All right. Here we go, Ray. Old Lady Periwinkle said, out at the home, we have our own magazine, and I'm the centerfold. That's because my blanks fold out.
Wrinkles.
Wrinkles. Okay. Need four to tie and five to win. She said wrinkles.
There are many choices. I chose wrinkles.
All right. Aaron?
I said jugs.
Jugs.
They could have been worse. Say it with commitment, you know?
Hello,
Boobettes.
Me. Boobettes. Now, let's see. You need three more to achieve a tie. Okay, John, we're up to you.
Wrinkles is an awfully good answer. I said teeth.
Oh. Teeth. All right, so that means Charlotte wins the game. What do you have, Martin Charles?
Knees.
Knees. Come on down there, Charlotte. Now, if you'll take your place right there, I'll be with you in a moment or so. Ray.
Bye-bye, Tom.
I really admire you.
Thank you.
What was your altitude you jumped in a parachute in?
Pardon me?
What altitude did you jump in?
3,000 feet.
3,000 feet.
200 miles an hour.
Don't pull her until I tell you to pull her. Wait a minute. I didn't dismiss her. My hand is still attached to her. I can't attach her.
Okay. Hello, Charlotte. Listen, we're going to switch to Hollywood Squares now. Here comes the rest of our furniture. And three more stars will make an entrance from the right here in a moment or so. John and I will trade places. We've got a lot more excitement coming along. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Hitachi's cassette patch music system, FM-AM stereo receiver, 7.5 watts per channel, belt drive turntable, magnetic cartridge, two-way hydrone cone speaker system, furnished by Hitachi. And now it's time for more of the match game, Hollywood Squares Hour, with Fred Travellina. From Dreamhouse, Bob Eubanks. From Another World, Christopher Rick. And taking over, the star of the Hollywood Squares, John Bauman.
Bye. Okay, we'll be right back to play Hollywood Squares. Come back to...
To the Hollywood Squares, and with me I have Charlotte T-O-E-R-C-K Turk.
That's right.
Yes. Well, spelling doesn't count, Charlotte. All that matters is that you've won the match game and you're ready to move on to Hollywood Squares. We have three brand new celebrities. Bob Eubanks.
Hello, John.
Thank you. Chris Rich.
Yay!
And Fred Cavalina. And whoever else may be with Fred. Hey, Mr. Eubanks, howdy, neighbor, huh?
Howdy, neighbor. John Bauman is my neighbor on one side, and John and Bo Derek on the other side, so you know which way I ride my horse, away from Bowser, for sure.
We have houses out in the country, and I have an easement on Bob's driveway. Thank you very much.
No, I have an easement on your driveway.
Yeah?
Yes.
We'll have to discuss this after we play Hollywood Squares. Here we go. I'm one of the few Jewish cowboys, though. I had a couple of relatives. Hopalong Yitzchak was one of them. I have a bit of explanation to do here. We have Linda Fleischman returning in the champion seat. She has been on the show once before. We had a bit of a problem with one of the questions, so we have brought her back. Aww. Welcome once again.
Thank you.
Now, it has been a while, Linda.
I'll never forget the question, ever.
Yeah, it has been a while. Why don't you just update us?
What was the problem with the question, John?
Pardon me, Bob?
What was the problem with the question?
I don't know. Just a problem with the question. Why don't you tell us a little bit about your life to date?
I live in Long Beach. I'm happily married. I have a 6-month-old baby at home, and I'm a flight attendant.
Terrific. Mm-hmm. Okay, welcome back.
Thank you.
To play Hollywood Squares. And we're going to play it till you hear the Time's Up bell. You probably remember this. You probably know it as well. Whoever is ahead goes on to play Supermatch. That's worth up to $30,000. First game's worth $100, $25 for every square. Linda, you have the champion seat. Pick a star and let's go.
I'll go with Bob.
Mr. Eubanks.
Yes, sir.
What are there more of in the United States, Bob? Little green Monopoly houses or real houses?
That's a tough question.
Laps? I'm trying to make this easy.
Little green Monopoly houses. Well, I would guess that there are probably more real houses in the United States.
He says there are more real houses. Agree or disagree for the first square?
I'm going to agree.
There are more little green Monopoly houses. No, you should have disagreed right off the bat.
Sorry,
with Mr. Eubanks. Your opponent gets the first square. There are almost 3 billion manufactured little green Monopoly houses. There are only 54 million real houses.
Who counted?
Even fewer hotels. Okay, Charlotte, you're playing. Oh, it's your move.
I'll go with Aaron, please.
Aaron Moran. From Happy Days. Does a moth have a brain?
I'm sorry.
Does a moth have a brain, or are they brainless?
You should know that.
girls, please.
I will say. What? I will say they are brainless.
She says moths are brainless. What do you say? A moth has a brain.
I knew that.
You should have disagreed, and it's even up. Your opponent gets that square. An X and an O.
A moth
so far.
Would have gotten that question right.
Okay, Linda Fleischman, your move, you're playing X.
I think I'm going to go with Nancy.
Nancy Frangione. From another world.
Jupiter.
What weighs more, Nancy? A newborn baby's heart or a wet cloth diaper?
I know what smells worse.
What do you say, Linda? Agree or disagree?
Could you repeat the question again?
What weighs more?
It weighs less. The heart weighs less.
What weighs more, a newborn baby's heart or a new cloth or a wet cloth diaper? She says a wet cloth diaper weighs more.
I agree.
A wet cloth diaper weighs more. Yes,
oh,
very well done.
Right.
Right to agree. You get the square. Wait a second. A newborn baby's heart weighs less than 1 ounce. Amazing.
Wow.
Amazing.
All right, Charlotte Turk, your move. You're playing
though. Research.
I'll go with James DeBlock.
All right, we educational. James Sloyan from O'Madeline. You rent your tomcat out as a stud for a female cat. Where will they mate quicker, your place or her place?
I would have to go with mine.
Okay.
I've seen your place.
Yeah.
It's a real sandbox.
For a block, Charlotte, which means that Linda will win if you miss this question. He says that the female cat, that the tomcat and the female cat will mate quicker at his place, the tomcat's place. Agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
They will mate quicker at
her place.
Sure, no, sure. Female cats are more comfortable mating at home. Your opponent gets that square and wins the first game. Okay. Our flight attendant is off to a flying start. She's got $175, but there's plenty of time. We're going to be back with a $200 game right after these messages.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour.
Join me, Bob Eubanks, for my picks from Card Sharks, Match Game Hollywood Squares, Family Feud, and The Newlywed Game. It's the best of Bob during Bobtober on Buzzer.
Concludes tomorrow, starting at 8.
I'm Bob Eubanks, and you're watching Buzzer. Let's play.
And now back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Square.
Okay, this is a $200 game, $25 once again for every square. Charlotte, since you lost the last game, you get to start this one.
I'll start with Aaron.
Aaron Moran.
Shh. Go ahead.
According to the Book of Modern Table Manners, Aaron, what should you do at a dinner party when you find a little green bug in your lettuce? Should you discreetly tell the hostess, or should you just push the food around on your plate so it looks like you're eating?
I would politely tell the waitress. Did you say waitress or hostess?
It's a hostess. Okay. It's a dinner party.
Hostess.
She says you should politely tell the hostess, agree or disagree, Charlotte.
Oh, you could eat it.
You should push the food around so it looks like you're eating. According to the Book of Modern Table Manners, your opponent gets that square. Well, that's... Can't wait till I make the Book of Modern Table Manners into a movie.
Call your
Okay,
turn.
Linda Fleischman, your move.
Okay, I'm going to go with Charles.
Charles Nelson Reilly. First time in Hollywood Squares.
Yay!
Charles, you are in San Quentin prison.
They just didn't catch me yet, that's all.
Is it possible for you to become the Birdman of San Quentin? Or aren't you allowed to have a bird in your cell?
I would think you could have a bird in your cell.
So you can become the Birdman of San Quentin. What
I'm going
say,
to
Linda?
Agree with Charles, yes.
Birds are not allowed in San Quentin. No, you should have disagreed with Charles, and your opponent gets that square. So there's an X and an O up there so far. Charlotte, you're playing O.
I'll go with Gene.
Mr. Raver.
Ready.
Your cow has just eaten some nails, Gene.
Oh. I told her not to do that.
According to the Veterinary Guide for Animal Owners, one way to solve the problem is to make her swallow something. Is it Pepto-Bismol or a magnet?
Well, the question is, basically, is Pepto-Bismol an emetic to a bovine creature?
Well, I don't know.
And I don't even know what I said.
Have you ever seen
And neither do we.
Let's see.
but
I'd say, you know, since a cow has two stomachs, it has that preliminary one. Therefore, the food wouldn't be too far down. So I would put the magnet in there, grab those nails, and gently pull them out.
Charlotte, he says, you should give that cow a magnet. Agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
You should. You should give the cow a magnet.
See, yes. I told you.
Cow eats nails. Give them. This is useful information. Okay. You get the square. Well done. Linda Fleischman, you're playing X.
Okay. I'm going to go with Martha to block, please.
You missed this one. Your opponent takes the game and the lead. Martha Smith from Scarecrow and Mrs. King.
Yes.
If you're like the majority of the 33,000 women surveyed in Glamour magazine.
I am. No, dude, all of them.
Are you happy with your weight, or do you think you're too fat?
I'm not like them, but if I were like them, I would think I was too fat.
Okay, to block, do you agree or disagree?
Well, I feel that way, so I'm going to agree with you, yes.
You do. You think you're too fat. Yes, you're right to agree, you get the square, and you do block. We, of course, think you're both just right, but that's very good play. Charlotte, shoes on the other foot, you're playing well.
I'll go with Chris to block.
Chris Rich from Another World. Every night, by the time your wife has finished removing her makeup, massaging her cuticles,
and
doing 20 push-ups, you are out of the mood.
So what else is new, John? What is this?
I should point out at this time that his wife is, in real life, is Nancy Frangione, who is in the second row on the end. According to Ann Landers, Chris, should your wife cut the routine and hop into bed, or should you browse through Playboy until she's ready?
I think she should nip the routine right in the bud and jump into bed.
Get right to it.
Is that the message,
Nancy? What do you say, Charlotte?
I'll agree.
Your wife should cut the routine. Yes. Jump into bed. You're right to agree. You get the square and you do block. Okay. So we have a strange pattern developing.
We sure do.
Yes. I'm glad you agree. Would you care to pick a star?
I will go with Fred.
Fred Travellina.
Hey. Hey.
Which came first, Fred? Gym neighbors or the yo-yo?
Well, that all depends, because lots of people think I'm a yo-yo. Golly. I can't believe it. Gym neighbors or the yo-yo?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I would, let's see, the yo-yo. That would have to be the yo-yo.
What do you say, Linda?
I'm going to disagree.
The yo-yo came first. No, you should have agreed with Fred. The yo-yo goes back to ancient times. Your opponent gets that square. Okay, so you got a couple of O's up there, Charlotte. Pick a star.
I believe I'll go with Bob to win.
Mm-hmm. Bob Eubanks, what costs more, raising the average American child to his 18th birthday?
Yes.
Or buying a brand new top-of-the-line Mercedes?
Raising a child. I've done that 3 times, and I can tell you that it's still costing money. It's raising a child.
For the game, agree or disagree, Charlotte?
I will agree.
Raising a child costs more. Yes, you're right to agree. You get the square, and you win the game! Well done. Raising a child to his 18th birthday costs around $90,000. Kids, be nice to your parents, huh? Okay, we're going to come back to the $300 game right after this.
thriller going. 350 for Charlotte and 225 for Linda. Linda, you get to start.
Okay, I'm going to go with Charles.
Charles Nelson Reilly.
Thank you.
Charles, your pet cat wants to avoid getting pregnant. Now, can you buy birth control pills for her? Or must she use other means?
Like rhythm.
She has to use other means.
Agree or disagree, Linda?
I'm going to agree.
You can buy birth control pills for your cat. No, you should have disagreed with Charles. Your opponent gets the first square. You might get a funny look at the drugstore, but you can do it. Okay, Charlotte, that's a break for you. You're playing O. Pick a star.
I'll go with Erin again.
Erin Moran.
Oh, yeah?
Erin. Listen carefully.
Okay.
You're a teenage girl. You live in a dump. And your father's a real slob. According to Ann Landers, is it okay to have your dates pick you up at a friend's house, or is there no reason for you to be ashamed of your home?
I don't think that I should be ashamed of where I live.
Agree or disagree, Charlotte?
I will disagree.
According to Ann Landers, there is no reason for you to be ashamed of your home. You should have agreed with Erin. Your opponent gets that square. Eh, just because you live in a dump and your father's a slob.
Back,
okay, Linda, that evens it up in this game. You were playing X.
Okay, I'm going to go with Nancy.
Nancy Frangione.
Yes.
You're cheating on your husband.
Uh-huh.
What?
You're cheating on your husband. According to Cosmopolitan's new etiquette guide, if someone asks if you're having an affair, should you tell them yes, tell them to mind their own business, or absolutely deny it?
You would never say yes. It would get back to the husband. If you tell them to mind their own business, that's implying that you're hiding something. I think that you should. What was the third one? No.
Absolutely deny.
This gets me nervous. Deny.
Deny. What do you say, Linda? Agree or disagree?
I'm going to disagree.
You should absolutely deny it. No, you should have listened to Nancy. Are you doing this, Nancy? You had that
down. I've had it down.
Your opponent gets that square.
Strategy.
Okay. Charlotte Turk, you're playing O. Pick a star.
Fred to win.
Mm-hmm. This could give you a pretty big lead. Fred Travellina, whoever else may be up there. Fred, your dinner guests are about to arrive, and your lettuce is all wet. According to Mary Ellen, should you put it in a pillowcase and spin dry it in your washing machine, or should you hang it from the antenna of your car and drive around the block?
Pat and I had this problem at San Clemente.
I would say put it in a towel and spin
put it
dry
in a pillowcase and spin dry.
Sure, real fast. You know.
Not okay, for the game, Charlotte. For the game and a pretty big lead. Agree or disagree?
I agree.
You should spin dry it in your washing machine. Yes, it's ridiculous as that sounds. The other one's more ridiculous. You get the square and a pretty decent sized lead. Congratulations. 725 to 250 for Linda Fleischman. But there is still time. We'll sweep all the O's and the solitary X off of the board, and we will move on to a $400 game. And Linda, you will start.
Okay, Charles, you might as well try again.
A glutton for punishment. Okay, this is it, Linda. Okay.
Mr. Reilly.
Yo.
You are a teacher, and the principal has asked you to wear a costume to school on Halloween. Now, according to Dress for Success expert John T. Malloy, is this unsuitable behavior for a teacher, or should you do it and have a good time?
Such a moving question. You should do it and have a good time.
I'm going to agree.
It's unsuitable behavior for a teacher.
Charlie,
well, the jinx continues. Your opponent gets that square. It is likely to cause discipline problems. Okay. Charlotte, another break for you. Pick a star.
I'll go with Erin, please.
Erin Moran.
Yes. Our lights are hot up here.
Very hot. It's getting very hot.
Thank you.
Well, don't touch that. When Morris the cat takes a business trip,
A lot of cats in this one, isn't there?
When Morris the cat takes a business trip, does he fly first class or does he travel in a cage with the baggage?
All first class all the way.
Agree or disagree?
Cat's in the business. Come on.
Agree or disagree, Charlotte?
I agree.
Morris the cat flies first class all the way. He hates to miss the movie. Yes. You're right for me. You get the square. Good going. Now what, Linda?
Well, I guess I'm going to go with Bob DeBlock.
Don't ask me any pregnant cat questions, please.
You missed this one. An astronomical lead for Charlotte.
Yes, that's true.
Bob.
John.
You drink.
Pardon me?
You drink.
I drink?
That's what it says here.
I don't.
Imagine you do. You drink and your favorite color is green. Which has a higher alcohol content? Creme de mal?
Creme de who?
You know what I mean. M-E-N-T-H-E.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Creme de mal.
Creme de
mal. Creme de mal. Yeah. Or Vicks NyQuil.
Which has the higher alcohol.
Oh. Right.
Well, I do drink Vicks NyQuil.
I knew it.
And I want you to know that it doesn't help your cold, but after you have enough of it, you don't care. I have to say the NyQuil.
Okay. He says Vicks NyQuil has the higher alcohol content. To Block, agree or disagree?
I'm going to agree.
Vicks NyQuil has the higher alcohol content.
I drink
content.
That too.
Yes.
That
you're right, you're right. Here at the screen, you can Block. Vicks NyQuil, 25%. Creme de mal, 21%. Doesn't matter. Go ahead. $775. Charlotte Kirk, congratulations.
Congratulations to her, too.
Very well done.
Thank you.
Go over there, join Drew Rayburn. You remember him. Get set for your shot at the big money. Well?
Well, it was fun.
Good. I'm glad we brought you back. We're clearing everything up here. You played very, very well. She just played a little bit better. You had $150 from your other appearance. You have $275 today. It's a total of $425. Linda Fleischman.
Great.
Good job.
Thank you, Aubrey.
Okay.
Thank you, John. Congratulations to the youth camp here. We'll be back with her and our nine stars for going to Big Money right after this.
Starting at noon, Buzzr is the place to play with our most popular shows.
That's why daytime is playtime.
Every day you must watch.
Weekdays starting at noon Eastern, only on Buzzer. Let's play.
And now, here to play the Super Match is Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Johnny O. Yes, indeed, we are going to play the Super Match, Charlotte. This is where you could win up to $30,000, shall we?
Yes.
All right, good luck to you. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Blank chest. If you give us the answer that they wrote down most frequently, we give you $1,000.
Yeah, yeah.
If you give us their second most popular answer, we give you $500, and the third pays $250. Any three of the nine stars can offer a little assistance here. One at a time, please.
Nancy.
Treasure chest.
Treasure chest is Nancy's.
John?
Oh, next on the line, I'd say hope chest.
Hope chest.
Fred.
Big chest.
Big chest?
Big chest.
He has a one-track mind, as you can see. All right. Or a two-track mind, depending on your viewpoint. So, we have big chest, hope chest, and treasure chest. Now you have to make a decision of choosing one of those three or rejecting them and giving us one of your own.
I'm going to go with treasure chest. Yeah.
Treasure chest. You think it's going to be up there? We'll find out right now. Let's go down to the bottom and reveal a $250 response. Community chest.
Hey!
That's what we all give to. All right. The $500 response says hope chest. That's a hopeful sign for you, Charlotte. Now, she's looking for treasure chest. Let's slide the big one. Treasure chest. Got it. Very good. All right. Now, Charlotte, you've got the $1,000. Time now for the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. After you've made your decision, we'll ask the star to reveal the hidden number. It'll be a 10 or 20 or a 30. There's 130 up there. We'll multiply that number by the $1,000 you've just won. Time now to choose a star.
John, please.
Oh, yeah.
John, let's see if it's a 10, a 20, or a 30. $20,000 what you're playing for. $20,000. All right. There you go, right on that little mark, facing me. Here we go. Ready, John?
Ready.
For $20,000, your job is to match him. Remember, Charlotte. Up and blank. Up and blank. He made up his mind very quickly. Collect the $20,000. All they have to do is give a little match with John there. Up and
down.
Up and down is what she says, John. That'll put the $20,000 in her purse.
Her purse is going up and up.
Aha! Total of $21,775. Congratulations to Charlotte. Well done. Okay, we'll be back with Charlotte, our stars, right after this.
Up next on Classic Concentration, you've matched two green takes. That means you get this episode and can take the next one. Back to back. Stay tuned.
find out which of the three stars had the big 3-0. Would you all grab the tab, give them a yank? 1, 2, 3, go. Gene! Jim had the big 3-0. All right, stars, we'll see you tomorrow. We'll see you tomorrow. Gene Rayburn inviting you to join us tomorrow.
John Bowen saying so long for the Match Game. I'm Chris Kranzauer.
I'm out of the studio audience. We'll receive you a deluxe inverter with a shorter with the energy saver control. This is designed to save on electricity. 7 push buttons provide up to 18 cycle selection. Solid cherry cutting board furnished by White Westinghouse. This is Johnny Olson speaking for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour of Art Goodson Television Productions.
Behind these numbers is a puzzle. Can you solve it? Will